During the production of Time Ghost, we knew we would have to tackle the challenge of authoring believable cloth deformations for our characters' realistic costumes. This is not an easy problem to solve, as we know that cloth is generally difficult to get right in 3D. To avoid the known limitations of the industry standard approaches for creating cloth in games, we needed to take a different path. In the meantime, we knew that our colleagues at Unity's engineering organization had been developing a real-time inference engine that unlocks the potential of using machine learning models with Unity. In this video, we will share our process and explain how we combine traditional animation workflows with cutting-edge ML to elevate the quality and realism achievable for real-time character animation, and specifically, cloth deformation. Our character modeling and rigging were done according to industry standards, allowing us to apply the usual motion capture data and perform keyframe animations on our rigged and skinned character model. Nevertheless, for the animation of our main character's outfit, we sought a more realistic looking solution beyond just a skinned mesh with additional blend shapes. Sentis, Unity's implementation of the Neural Network Exchange, or NNX framework, is a core pillar in our character pipeline. By implementing Sentis, we are able to train a machine learning model using our own dataset of high-quality, realistic offline cloth simulations and deploy the model at runtime. How do we go about using the detailed but heavy offline simulation data in a real-time environment? First, we created 70 poses of our character model for each character's performance, blending from a neutral pose to the final extreme pose over 30 frames. In Marvelous Designer, we simulate the pattern-based cloth and are able to capture the cloth deformation behavior from these 70 movements. The next step was to extract the delta values, which is the difference between the skinned mesh and the simulated mesh. This calculation could be done in Maya or any other DCC, where you have access to model vertex data. The process involves reversing the skin deformation while maintaining the simulated deformation data. To train a runtime model, we use TensorFlow to design and train a custom model based on the extracted data. The extracted data is fed into a feed-forward neural network, or FNN, which inputs the character's joint orientations and outputs the extracted vertex delta positions. In Unity, the deformation data is applied on top of our skinned character mesh and processed in patches to maintain a small runtime model. All in all, it's possible to go from existing cloth simulations prepared in DCC, in our case, Marvelous Designer, to real-time deformations in Unity within a couple of hours. In the case of Time Ghost, we were able to reduce 2.5 gigabytes of offline deformation data to a single 45 megabyte ONNX model, thereby enabling us to deform 120K vertices in 0.8 milliseconds on the GPU. For more versatile and dynamic cloth behavior of the coats on the background soldiers seen in the Time Ghost cinematic, we used an additional joint-based deformation model. By training the model with simulations of various poses of the coat, the model was deployed to enhance the soldier's lower coat behavior. We chose this method, believing that the achieved real-time deformations of the fabric were more natural than using current available real-time physics. The integration of Sentis not only improves our visual fidelity, achieving highly realistic and dynamic deformations, but also provides a workflow that is efficient and adaptive to the needs of high-quality game development. In addition, the performance results we are getting with Sentis are so promising that we have started to look into whether the same pipeline can be applied to mobile development as well. Unity's engineers already made some initial validation steps and have confirmed that Sentis can run our character with realistically deforming cloth, even on a mobile phone. And while high fidelity is not very typical for mobile game development, the implication of being able to use the machine learning-based approach for mobile target platforms is that deformations and stylized animations can also become way more detailed and beautiful than what has been possible so far. A demo project is now available for download on the Unity Asset Store. It includes a Unity 6 sample scene with the character and documentation describing the model and processes of training. You will also gain access to the vertex-based deformation model. If you have your own character simulation data, you will be able to train the model with your specific simulation sets and hopefully breathe new life into your character animation.